Hello students, welcome to the next lecture on the differential equation. Today I will explain you the Bernoulli differential equation, that is of the form dy over dx plus py is q y raised to power n. Myself Dr. Hishkar, you can simply follow my YouTube channel where there is a playlist of the mathematics 2 and you can see the previous lectures on the variable separable, linear, homogeneous, exact differential equation, integrating factor and many more available in this complete syllabus of this playlist. Now, what is the objective of this lecture? We will see how you can solve the differential equation of this kind. And clearly say, if I look about this second example, you can solve this problem by the variable separable method easily, because I can written this number as x raised to power 4 minus xy. If I take xy as a common, then y cube minus 1. So therefore, I can written this number as here. Fine, then you can easily solve this by the variable separable. But if you look about this, this is not solvable by variable separable. Moreover, none of the differential equation is solvable by homogeneous method. For example, if I look about here, then your coefficient of dy by dx should be 1. Clearly say it is not homogeneous. Also, it is not solvable by linear differential equation. So how you can solve this? For that, I will explain you the Bernoulli equation. So as we have discussed the last lectures, homogeneous, linear differential and separable, which is of first order, first degree. Then you can see that if I solve these problems, you can easily solve by linear differential equation. Make sure whenever you are using this method, in that case, your integrating factor is e raised to power pdx. Make sure this q is independent of y. That is the most important condition. And if you look out here, clearly say this, you can find a p, but here it is not independent of y. It means it is not solvable by integrating factor. Similarly, if you look about this side, again the linear y is present, but y square is also given to you. So it means it is not linear in y. So then how you can solve that? For this, we need a Bernoulli differential equation. What is the equation of that? Whenever you have a differential equation of this form, right hand side is y raised to power n. N can be any number apart from the 0 and 1. Because if n is equal to 0, what will happen of this? It is only my qy, then it is my linear. When n is equal to 1, then I can rearrange them. It is a p minus q of y is 0. Fine. Then again you can solve by linear. So remember, whenever you find a degree of y is 1 and any of the other degree, then you can solve by the using Bernoulli equation. And it's one of the easiest lecture you can see at the end of this video. So whenever you are identifying that it's a Bernoulli differential equation, you can change into this form. Make sure, as I told you again, this q is independent of y. Whenever you find it is independent of y, then you can call as a linear differential equation. And make sure p, the coefficient of the y is a p. How you can do that? I can simply take the substitution as y is 1, y is t is equal to y raised to power 1 minus n. When I substitute this value here, then it converted into the linear differential equation. And once you know it's a linear, you can solve by using here integrating factor this and here. Now, how you can solve that? Let me firstly give you the smallest discussion. If I divide it by y raised to power n on the both side, and then I can use this substitution here, then can you find the value of that dt by dx? It is, I can return this number as 1 minus n. So 1 minus n y raised to power minus n dy over dx. So can you find the value of 1 over n dy over dx from this case? 1 minus n I can return as here. Fine. Is it okay? Then I can substitute this value at here. I can substitute this value this. So what is the meaning of that? It is 1 over 1 minus n dt over dx plus 1 over, this will be my t into px, and the right hand side is my qx. Fine. Make sure the coefficient of the differential form should be 1. I can multiply both sides by 1 minus n. It becomes my here. and clearly say the dependent variable is my t and the right hand side is independent of t. So once it is independent of t, it means it is a linear. So once it's a linear, how you can solve that? You can use the integrating factor. What is the integrating factor is? Here is 1 minus n px into dx. Once you get the integrating factor, how you can find the solution? Q, Q is my right hand side. So it is 1 minus n into of here. So what is the t? I can substitute the value of the t as here. You will get this is my required solution. So I can use this approach to solve this integration in a quick manner. For examples, so you have the two different kind of the Bernoulli equation. One is when you have the independent variable x and dependent variable y from here. In this case, the independent variable is my y and dependent variable is my x. And make sure once it is x, then it should be free from x. If it is x raised to power n, then we call it as the Bernoulli differential equation. However, in this case, the dependent variable is y. So whenever it is written in the y raised to power n, then it is Bernoulli in y. So then you can use this simple formula. You can write this formula on your copy. Integrating factor is instead of the pdx, it is a 1 minus n, and I can written like here. If it is Bernoulli equation dependent in the x, then I can replace x to y in this formula. You can see it is a x raised to power 1 minus n, 1 minus n and q of y d. So let's see how you can solve that. Firstly, you can see, can you solve this problem by variable separable? Yes, you can do that, because I can solve this, I can write this value as of this x cube minus 1, then I can write this is x into dx. Then you can partial fraction, fine. You can use the partial fraction of y cube minus 1, you can solve it. Is it a linear? Is it homogeneous? It is not homogeneous. Why? Because if I write here, you clearly say the degree of the each term is not same. So can you apply the homogeneous method? No. Is it a linear? You can again see, yes, y is appear, but the simultaneously y raised to power 4 is also present. So it means this problem is solved by Bernoulli differential equation or the variable separable. So let me firstly start with the Bernoulli. Make sure the coefficient of the dy over dx to be 1. If it is not, you can make them. So now it is here. You can compare this, because y is my here. What is my px? Px is coefficient of the y, x. What is my qx? Coefficient of y raised to power n. What is my n? N is my 4. Is it clear? Then how you can solve? You have to use the integrating factor. So if I substitute here, what is a 1 minus n? It's a minus 3. P is my x. So it's a minus 3x of dx. So can you integrate that? It is my minus 3x square over 2. Fine. This is my integrating factor. Now I can substitute here. What is the n? N is my 4. So it's a minus 3. Integrating factor is minus 3x square over 2. N is my 4. Is e raised to power minus 3x square over 2 into dx plus c. Fine. Now how you can solve that? Again, a very simple. If I simply put minus 3x square over 2 as my t, then what is the derivative of this? Minus 3x dx is equal to dt. So minus 3x dx is equal to dt. So this expression becomes my e raised to power t of dt. So what is the integration of this? E raised to power t. So what is the right answer of this? I can return this is 1 over y cube e raised to power 3 x square over 2. This is e raised to power t. T is my of this plus c is my, this is the right answer of this problem, where c is the arbitrary constant. Or you can also write, I can return is a 1 over y cube, I can divide it by this plus c e raised to power 3 x square over. Look at this. Firstly, you can make the coefficient of the dx over dy to be 1. So it is x cube y minus x over y. So clearly say it is not homogeneous. This problem is not solvable by homogeneous. Again, it is not solvable by variable separable method. Is it a linear in y? No. It is not linear in y because y appears in the denominator. Is it linear in x? Yes, x appears, but again the x cube is also present. It means it is linear in y but in the form of Bernoulli. So you can solve this equation by Bernoulli. If this term is not present, for example, if this term is not present, then you can easily solve this problem by linear differential equation in x. So where p is my 1 over y, q is my y. But right now it's a present of the x cube. So it means you can't solve like here. So firstly, I can write here, if you compare this by x is my dependent variable, what is my p of y, coefficient of the x? Q of y is coefficient of x raised to power n, that is my y, n is my 3. Fine. Once you find all these values, then your target is very simple. Now the dependent variable is my x. So your integrating factor is with respect to y and x of this. I can substitute this value, n is my 3, it is my minus of 2, p of y is my here, minus 2 over y dy. So can you solve this integration? Minus log of or ln of y. So what is the of this? It is a 1 over y square. I can return this number as log y raised to power minus 2, e of log is 1 over y square. So integrating factor is 1 over y square. I can substitute here, n is my 3, so it is a minus of 2, 1 over y square. N is my minus, n is my 3, so it's a minus 2. Q is my y of 1 over y square plus c. So what is that? 1 over y is my ln of y plus c. It is 1 over x square, y square is the required answer of the problem. You just need to integrate it and you will get your right answer as here. Look at this another question. Again, firstly, make the coefficient of this to be 1. It can be written here. Again, you can see it is not a homogeneous because the degree are not same. It is linear in y, but y power is also present. It means this problem is solved by Bernoulli differential equation. Can you solve this problem by variable separable? You can see if I divide it by x here, it will be my this. Clearly say it. You can't separate the variable, but because y raised to power 1 is present, so it means this problem is solvable by linear in y, but because of y square, it is a Bernoulli in y. So you can compare this by here. What is my p? P is my minus 2 over x. Q is the coefficient of y raised to power n. It is x square and n is my 2. I can substitute this value here. E, what is the 1 minus n? It's a minus 1 and it's a minus of 2 by x. It's a plus 2 over x. What is the integration of this? 2 log of x. It is 2 log x square. So the answer is x square. So integrating factor is my x square. I can substitute here y of minus 1 into x square. It is minus 1. What is the q? Q is my x square into x square of dx plus c. So this is my x raised to power 4. What is the integration of the x raised to power 4? X raised to power 5 over 5. I can return this is x square over y is the right answer of the where c is my arbitrary constant. Now look at this one. So can you solve this equation? It is my 0. Fine. So if I found, either you can find the dy over dx or you can find the dx over dy. So let me firstly find what is the value of the dx over dy. So I can return this number as minus 3 over y minus 3 e raised to power x y raised to power 4. So clearly say it is not a homogeneous. Variable separable method is not applicable. Is it linear in x? Because I choose as a x here. But x in the denominator, so it is not in linear x. Can it be the linear in y? It linear in y only when you find the dy over dx. So if I found here, it is my this case over minus 3. So you can see value of y is my 1. So it is linear in y. But y power 4 is also present. It means this problem is solved by Bernoulli differential equation. So I can found the value of the dy over dx firstly from this. It is my minus, it can be written as a plus y over 3, which is e raised to power x, y raised to power 4. Fine. Now I can, because y is my dependent variable, I can compare with the y. So what is my px, coefficient of the y, 1 over 3. Qx, coefficient of y raised to power n. What is the n? N is my 4. So once you find that, I can use this formula here. What is the n? 4 is a minus 3 into 1 by 3. So minus 3 into 1 over 3. So what is that? It's a e raised to power minus 1. That is e raised to power minus x. I can substitute here y minus 3 e raised to power minus x. It's a minus 3. Q is my e raised to power plus x. E raised to power minus x into dx. So what is the integration of this? It's a 1. Integration of the 1 is my, this is my 1. Integration of the 1 is my x. So 3x plus c is the right answer of this problem. You can write as a reciprocal of this, otherwise this will be the right answer of the problem. Look at this another one. Again, either you can find the dx over dy or dy over dx. So let me firstly find the dx over dy. It will be minus x over 2y plus x cube cos x y square. So clearly say it is not homogeneous. It is not solved by variable separable. It is not in linear. Why? Because x appears in the denominator. When you find the linear in x, it always appears only in the numerator. So it is not here. Can I reciprocal them? What is the dy over dx from here? It is x cube cos x into y square divided by minus x. So can it be the linear in y? How you can check the linear in y? If you find the y term appears, yes, y appears, but simultaneously y square is also appear. It means this problem is solved by Bernoulli. So I can write this equation in the Bernoulli form. Linear, that is, this is my linear. I can write on the left hand side, it's a minus, I can written as a plus 2y over x, and the rest of the part on the right hand side, x square cos x into y square. Fine. Now if you compare by differential equation, you will get p is my here, this is my p, q is my coefficient of the y raised to power n, and n is my 2. I can substitute this value here. What is the n? Is 2, it's a minus 1 into p is my 2 over x. So what is the integration of this? Minus 2 log x. It is 1 over x square. I can substitute 1 over x square as here. Minus 1, 1 over x square is a minus 1. It's a minus x square cos x into 1 over x square plus c. X square will be cancelled out. Minus minus plus integration of the cos x into dx. What is the integration of the cos x? Is a sin x plus c. I can return this is 1 over x square. Y is the right answer of this problem. Look at this another one. Firstly, make the coefficient of this as a 1. Always make sure this coefficient should be 1. Whether it's a homogeneous, whether it's a linear, whether it's a variable separable or anything. So I can written as a 4x plus 5 whole square divided by 2 times cos x of y cube. So clearly say this problem is not homogeneous. Variable separable again you can't apply. Is it linear in y? We can see yes, it is a linear in y, but y cube is also present. So it means this problem is solved by Bernoulli in y. Fine. So if you solve this, then this will be my coefficient of the y is my p, this complete is my q, and n will be my 3. Now I can find the integrating factor. 1 minus n is a minus of 2 into px. tan x over 2. Fine. So what is that? E raised to power minus, what is the integration of the tan is plus log of cos x. So the integration of this is my cos x. So integrating factor is my cos x. I can substitute here. It's a minus of 2 into cos x. It's a minus of 2 q into x. This is my q. If I multiply this term by cos x, you will get as only 4x plus 5 square divided by 2. Fine. Now this will be, so this 2 is also cancelled. What is the integration of 4x plus 5 square? Either you can open the square, this plus 25 plus 40x, and then integration of this will be 16x cube over 3 plus 25x plus 40x square over 2. Or how you can integrate them? You can integrate directly as 4x plus 5 raised to power 3 over 3 into derivative of this. So that is my right answer. This y square I can return in the denominator. So it is a 4312, I can return like here. Look at one more thing. Again, firstly make the coefficient of dy by dx to be 1. If I divide it by x, it is x ln x minus y over x. Clearly say it is not a homogeneous. You can't solve by the homogeneous method. Again, the variable separable is not applicable. Is it linear in y? Is it linear in y? Yes, the value of y 1, but simultaneously y square is also present. That means y raised to power n is present. It means this problem is solved by Bernoulli differential equation. So what is my p? If I compare them, you will get p as 1 over x, q is my here, n is my 2. I can substitute this value here. N is my 2, it's a minus 1, p is my 1 over x. So what is the integration of this? It's a minus log x. So it is 1 over x. I can substitute here. N is my 2, so it's a minus 1. 1 over x, it's a minus 1. Q is my x ln x into 1 over x. So it will be cancelled out. So it is minus integration of ln x into dx. So can you find the integration of this? I can take as a 1. So it will be first function. What is the integration of u into v? First function, integration of the second function minus derivative of the first function into integration of second function. So I can apply the same rule. First one, integration of the one is x minus integration derivative of the first function, integration of the second function. Fine. So it will be cancelled out. So integration of the one, again the x, it is L here. Fine. Plus C, minus is outside. So I can take minus x as a common. So this value becomes my 1 over y into x. I can take, because of this negative, I can take x as a common, minus x as a common. So it's a 1 minus ln x plus c is the right answer of this problem. So you can see, I can solve this by it here. You will get as the required answer. I hope you can like, you can subscribe and comment on my videos as well. Look at this another one. Again, you can see because of this y raised to power n, I can solve this problem by Bernoulli differential equation, although the coefficient is also 1. So can you compare them? What is the p? Coefficient of the y, minus cot x. Q, coefficient of y raised to power n, and n will be my 3. Then you can substitute this formula here. E raised to power 1 minus n minus 2 px is minus minus plus cot x into dx. So what is the integration of the cot x? Is a log of sin x. So what is the integration of this? Is a sin square x, because this 2 I can return as here. So integrating factor is my sin square x. I can substitute here. It's a y raised to power minus 2 sin square x this is minus 2, it's a cosecant x into sine square x of dx. So it is a minus of 2. I can return this cosecant is 1 over sine x. So 1 sine x and 1, this value will be cancelled out. So it is only sine x dx. So what is the integration of the sine x? It's a minus cos x. So minus minus plus 2 cos x plus c is the, I can return this is y square sine square x is the required answer of this problem, where c is my arbitrary constant. You can put a comments and the like on this video as well. Look at one more example. Again, you have to firstly make the coefficient to be a 1. So it is x y cube minus y over x. Clearly say it's a y raised to power n term present, and the y you can apply the Bernoulli differential equation. So I can write this y over x on the left hand side. It is written here. What is my p? Coefficient of the x. Q, coefficient of the y raised to power n, and n is my 3. Then I can substitute this value here. It is e raised to power n is my 3, is a minus 2 into 1 over x. So what is that? It is e raised to power minus 2 log x, 1 over x square. I can substitute here. This is my minus of 2, 1 over x square, minus of 2, q. Q is my x, and 1 over x square plus c. So this value I can return as a x square, y square. This value will be 1 over x. So 1 over x I can return as a log x plus c is the required answer. So 1 over x square, y square into minus 2 log x plus c, where c is my arbitrary constant. I hope you understand this lecture and in an easier manner. So these 5 questions are exercise for you. You can see, solve these questions and check your answers. These are the another 6 questions. These are again the exercise for you. You can solve all these 11 questions and check whether these answers are match or not. I hope you can like, you can comment on videos as well. We will see the next lecture on the exact differential equation. Till then, you can simply like, share and comment on video. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.